It's time.
You know, hey, what's up, everybody? This is Rafa Sparza, just coming to you guys live from the LA Jiu-Jitsu Club on this wonderful Thursday. Thursday morning. I'm joined by my good friend H&M Holland.
That was good.
Thank you. I know, I'm quite funny. Hey guys, here's the thing. JM hosts his own podcast. It's called the Finishers MMA Podcast. Correct?
Yeah, yeah. I got a shirt on right now.
Check it out. Oh,
I didn't even know that.
Oh,
that was totally random. I slept.
Look at what is that? That's great.
Yeah, do you see that in the camera?
That's great. You look can at that. Find. Yeah. You know, I don't really care for other podcasts, but I don't mind yours because you see. I mean, you're in front of me right now, but I'll talk to you later. Obviously, it is a pleasure to host you here at the LA Jiu-Jitsu Club. We're going to get to why you're in town. But before we do, we want to say hello to everybody joining us right now. Feel free to go ahead and comment in on this conversation. We are Facebook Live, which means that you guys are part of the show. If you have questions, comments, jokes, things that you would like to ask right now, feel free to chime in. You don't want any of that?
No jokes.
No jokes?
They're going to say mean things, maybe.
They're not going to say mean things about
oh,
you.
Okay. All right.
Trust me. It's probably not going to be about
you. Yeah, I don't know.
We've also got Eric Medina over on the sidelines as my Ed McMahon, just doing nothing but eating chicken soup.
Good morning.
Yep, he can hear it all the way over on the side. If you guys can hear us, go ahead and give us a hell yeah on the social meets. But anyway, thank you guys for joining us. We look forward to having a little bit of a conversation with y'all. I'm going to start off with this. JM, tell me how you got started in jiu-jitsu. How did this whole journey start for you?
Terrible MMA fighter. I was a guy that liked striking. And I was taught to like kind of use wrestling backwards to keep the fight standing. And after a while, after fighting like a million times for free, not a million, but a lot, I figured out like, hey, I could, you know, I got into Eddie's stuff and was like, you know, if I was dangerous off my back, maybe people wouldn't take me down as much. And like, I just got into jiu-jitsu at a certain point. Like it came to a point where I was either going to go pro with MMA or, like kind of, I had to make a move. I was like 20, 22. I was young, I think. I don't know. And I went to my camp. And I was like, hey, am I going to ever go pro in MMA? And they, like, laughed at me, basically. So I was like, okay, I'm going to get
good
at jiu-jitsu.
Always a good sign, by the way.
I was like, yeah, like, all right. I've been wasting my time this whole time. So, just got into jiu-jitsu. Like, I've been grappling since I've been a kid. Like, I've been doing it a long time, but I've been doing it wrong for a long time. You understand what I'm saying?
What were you doing wrong?
Like when I was a kid, like I knew how to grapple, like I knew like triangles, arm bars, but I wasn't at like a Hensel Gracie or something like that. Like out east, I was at like a, you know, I was at my local, you know, martial arts school, and you know, I knew how to grapple. I wrestled and everything, triangle chokes, arm bars, guard passes, the whole bit, you know. And then I was doing MMA, thinking I knew jiu-jitsu, like really believing I knew, like I was a solid like. Good jiu-jitsu guy. Like I knew at least enough to get me by.
Okay.
Like I was a good enough striker, you know. And then I started really doing jiu-jitsu and I was like, holy crap, like guys are good, you know what I mean? Like I can't believe it now. Like I can't, you know, now you can't believe like wow, I actually fought without even knowing what I know now, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's weird.
How is it that you decide that you really want to start making grappling as a competitive thing, like you really want to make yourself immersed in that world?
It's just always something that, competing is always something you did. Like, you know, I never not, like whether it was boxing or kickboxing or old karate tournaments or, you know, I did Nagas like way back, you know, and Grappler's Quest. Just it's something you did, you know what I mean? I hate it. I hate competing.
Yeah?
Yeah, no one likes competing. I mean, some guys like competing, but like, I hate competing. Cutting weight and the stress, it's stressful, man. I think of a lot. I'm like a very introverted person in that. Like, I think a lot. Man, it sucks. It sucks competing. But, like, after it's over, you're so glad you did it. You know what I mean?
Is it
you're
that like, you like the it. Opportunity to roll with new people and try new shit out? That is what is the addicting part of it? Or because... it's a weird thing to be like, I hate competing. Also, catch me at EVI 11. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be great.
I hate competing. I hate it. Like if I'm like, you gotta do it because like this is what I chose to do. Mm. Like I didn't choose to have an office job and all that stuff. When there's nothing wrong with that, I'm just saying. Like I chose to teach jiu-jitsu, and there's nothing wrong with not competing if you teach jiu-jitsu.
Sure,
but just for me, like, you know, my body's, you know, healthy and, you know, I'm young. And I should at least have tried. Like, you should try. Like, you know what I mean? I don't want my students, I don't want to ever come at my students with something that, like, if they're scared, I could never just tell them whatever I think I read in a book. Like, I want to know what they're going through, you know? And I didn't even take it as far as fighting pro MMA or anything like that. Like, you know, but dealing with injuries or nerves or, you know, like, Eddie does that for me. Like, Eddie will say some shit to me that totally settles me down. He'll say the right thing, you know, because he's been in these, like, situations. And sure. I'll, you know, if you're going to be a good instructor, if you want to get people high level, like, I don't want to look at Grace like, well, just good luck, Grace. You know what I mean? I want to be like, I want to understand what she's going through. And I hate competing. But, like, in 10 years from now when I'm, like, a 37-year-old man and, like, I got an 18-year-old kid, it's his first fight or something, I can look at him in the eye and just be like...
Oh, sorry. When you said you're a 37-year-old no, like man, a, you got an 18-year-old kid, I was like, where did he come from?
No, like a... Like, just like a student.
A student,
yeah,
sure.
Not like an actual biological child.
I was like, I don't know what kind of sciences you guys are doing over at the Bethlehem.
That would be cool, though.
But
if I could grow an 18-year-old kid in 10 years.
Just incubate some sort of warrior that you got ready to go.
My shit is very potent. Just my seed.
It just doubles the edge. And we want to say what's up to John Battle, who just wrote...
Oh, shit. Look what's at up, that. John Battle? That guy.
Tell me a little bit about that guy.
Mike Davila, dude. Those guys are all my my East Coast... compadres.
Yeah.
They're all my enemies, but my friends.
They're your enemies and your friends?
Yeah, frenemies, because we compete against each other.
Interesting.
John Battle hooked me when I was a purple belt, and Mike Davila fucking rear naked choked me.
Rude.
Fucking assholes.
Unnecessary, guys.
And I'm an EBI, bitch. How's that? No, I'm kidding. Wow. No, I'm kidding. They know I'm kidding.
But, of course they do.
Those guys, dude, you guys want to look out for those two. Like, John Battle, some of the slickest jiu-jitsu. He's fighting at the Radius Invitational. This weekend in Fairfield, Connecticut. Dude, those guys are monsters. Mike Davila's got something coming up, like the Submission Underground event, I think, out east. Those guys are both... I mean, Mike Davila was in EBI, but it's Battle's true. Coming up. He could kill monsters. Like, Battle's good.
Yeah,
he's a slick dude.
I've seen some of Battle's matches, so I understand. It's good stuff, man. All right. But enough about them. Ooh. The show's not about them. The show's about you, sir.
Oh.
Okay? So let's stay on focused here. We want to say hello to everybody watching and joining us. Feel free to join in. If you guys want to go ahead and give us some likes, you can make those little acid trip happy faces
no one
and
likes
shares.
This. No one
Nobody likes
this.
Those? What the fuck are you talking
no
about?
No one likes this.
Nobody
Who
likes
the hell's J.M. Holland? Get him out of here.
And I'm an EBI bitch. Laughing, crying face. Excellent.
Yeah.
All right, so before we get to talking a little bit about EBI, there's something that I wanted to go ahead and bring up here, which is this. I find you to be a fascinating person in the facial region.
Oh, thanks, man.
You, did you, what did you
call I just me? Called you babe.
Okay, you didn't need to do that.
That was instinct.
It was.
That was
it
instinct.
It was really awkward, and I'm almost about to rescind all
Sorry.
The compliments I've
Sorry.
Got here.
I'm new.
But
I'm new here.
What I want to go ahead and bring up and enlighten you guys, maybe if you don't know at home, JM, like, look at that face. Look at what you're doing. You have this, like, it's kind of like a mean mug, but it's, like, almost Salvador Dali-esque.
Thank you.
A little Vincent Price in there as well. Like, you really
can work the
move this.
In
so,
your face.
So what is it? Because I see you posing all the time in photos with, like, your students and your friends and all that. Like, what is the go-to for you?
The go-to is just swole guy. I just flex really hard.
Like, pretty good. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's
like
the one.
Like the Popeye?
Yeah, when you do that. Because it's funny you bring that up, guys, because here's what I'm going to go ahead and do. I haven't shown him any of these photos, but I want to get the story behind these photos. I want to get the real insight into the JM, because guess what? He's a killer on the mats. I've gotten the opportunity to roll with
Thank
you. You're
man.
Quite good.
Thank you.
But he's also very goofy and enjoys himself. Thanks, Mike. I know
Don't
Salvador
enjoy
Dali
yourself. It's not good for you. Don't have fun doing this shit.
So, I'm going to ask you to tell me
okay,
a little bit about these photos. Tell me the mentality behind these. All right, and we go in 3, 2, boom. All right.
Oh, shit.
What's this guy
Look at
thinking?
That mustache, dude.
What is that guy thinking right there?
I'm teaching kickboxing class, and I'm being, like, super deadly. Like, someone came in and, like, just started taking pictures. Like, some of my students, like, are all photographers.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So, I'm just teaching kickboxing class, and he's running around with this crazy camera. So, I just start posing. That's
okay.
the first one I hit, like
okay.
a kung fu karate.
Okay.
Serious.
I like it's, but you have a very serious look about you.
Yeah.
That's like, whoa! Don't come at me.
Yeah,
but
I'm
your
totally
face
kidding.
Is also inviting. Though.
I'm totally kidding.
Are you?
I'm totally not serious here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sometimes I can't tell, but it's impressive either way.
Thank you.
All right. What's going on here?
That's Zach Makovsky.
Okay.
He's a good friend of ours. He comes down. He's actually from Bethlehem.
Okay.
So when he's not training at TriStar, he trains, you know, for the holidays and shit. He comes down. Sure. Anyway, he's a cool kid, and we had a party at the school,
mm-hmm.
and we were cleaning up, and this song came on called Push It.
Yeah.
And there's this dance move. You ever see that? There's a kid doing a dance move.
Yeah.
Dude, he's pushing. He's like pushing the cart.
I want to go straight to. Can you demonstrate
yeah,
that?
Yeah, he's like pushing the uh-huh. shopping cart. It's uh-huh. like push it, push it.
Yep.
Push it, push it. And that's like the. We were like just. We got like a little drink out of tipsy. And the song came on. I was just dancing around the school like that as we were cleaning.
Because every time. I want to say for the tell me a little bit about the show The Art, because I think I saw a promotional poster with you looking like doing what was that?
The Show The Art poster was mm-hmm. an overhook and a wrist.
But it looked like
people thought I was frying eggs.
It was frying eggs. I thought you were doing like a Fat Joe lean back kind of thing.
No, that's an overhook and a wrist right there. That's Jean-Jacques. That's me, like, if I had butterfly hooks in, that'd be me, what I look like, mid-sweep.
But I guess my question is, why was that the promotional poster?
Because everyone does this.
Yeah.
Everyone does. And I do the mean mugs too, like, you know, but I don't want people to actually think I'm, like, I don't actually buy into I'm tough. Like, you understand? Mm-hmm. Like, other people might think that I think I'm tough.
Sure.
But I just do the other shit because I don't take myself seriously. Like, people take themselves super serious.
Well, I can tell that because we're going to go to another couple photos that will show as much. All right, so we already did the one. Let's go to this one now. And boom. Okay.
Oh, Herb Chow.
Tell Dude, me about Herb Chow.
Herb Chow is, he started out as a 10th planet Ronin, which like he's like a dude that just, boom. And now he's at Fairfield, Connecticut. He trains with those guys. But he's a huge supporter of me and Zach's. And he loves Grace, obviously. Like, dude, he's at Super Fights of Mine. He comes down and trains at the school with us. He stays at our house. You know, and dude, he actually trains. Like, that's the beauty of it. Like, a lot of people bust Herb's balls. And the dope thing is Herb holds it down on the mat. Like, he'll come to a seminar, dude. He's rolling with us. He's rolling with Herb's the man, dude.
Dude, that's awesome.
He,
man.
Like, reps. He's actually, like, a lot of these dudes just want to be, like, you know, down with 10th Planet or whatever, but not even train, really.
Dude.
Herb's about it.
That's awesome.
100%. And he's always a huge supporter of ours. I love Herb.
All right, now tell me again about the eyebrow. So that's that, because it's almost people's eyebrow here.
Yeah, well, that's exactly what it is.
Oh,
that's
it is?
Exactly, like, when I was
really
a kid.
I'm really good at reading what you think.
When I was a kid, like, I couldn't do it, and The Rock was the shit. So I would, like, go in the bathroom, and I would, like, just hold this eyebrow down, or I would hold this one down, and I would just flex both of them until I could just, because I just wanted to be able to move that eyebrow. I just did this for like a week.
Wow.
I remember I was at my grandmother's house and I wanted the people's eyebrow.
See, kids, you aren't just born with talent.
Gotta put that work in, guys.
Gotta get the reps in.
Reps.
You gotta get that in there. All right.
Reps.
Let's go to this next photo, okay? Because this will, like, I think it explains your current game.
Oh, yeah.
That's the Popeye. I said it was Popeye, and you said it was Popeye.
I am leveling up, yeah.
I'm looking at this, and I'm thinking to myself, I have gotten every one of your instincts correct that I have guessed.
That's Popeye, yeah.
Wow, that's incredible.
I mean, it's just the huge yoke dude.
Mm-hmm.
That's who I'm trying to be at that moment. And that's who I am, really.
But
look at me.
The contrast between you and Marvin, who, by the way, shout out Marvin, is... It's intense,
mm-hmm.
but it's perfect.
Yeah, dude, Marvin's the man. He was at our school for, like, a seminar recently. And, dude, one of the most... He gets me fired up about jiu-jitsu.
Mm.
Like, he'll come in, we'll start talking shit about jiu-jitsu.
Mm-hmm.
And next thing you know, it's like, we're getting hype. I gotta, like, calm myself down. Because he's talking shit, I'm talking shit. you know, like, and just because a lot of the time, dude, like... When you're around... You get to be around other competitors. And then you get to be around someone that's like... Dude, fuck that. You could beat that dude. Like, you're good.
Yeah.
Like, and
yeah.
Like, Marvin will do that for you. Marvin's the man.
Dude, that's awesome. And congratulations. I think Marvin's next video just got another 11 million views. So, Marvin, thank you for propping up jiu-jitsu and social media. There are football games that don't even
have
11 million
views. That's my hate face. Look at this.
Oh, you don't like that? hey, look at this. Marvin's somebody, got, you know, somebody order a small coffee over here.
Marvin is sponsored by Phalanx now, so he wears Phalanx. Rash. I bust his balls. He was in class the other night, and he had Phalanx everything. I'm like, ooh, I'm Marvin.
That's so weird.
Phalanx.
Listen, there's nothing I hate more than oddly throwing in sponsorships that just don't make any sense. But while we're on it, Asgard 503 puts together a beautiful shirt. I just happen to be wearing one right here. It says Jiu-Jitsu in a YouTube form, because guess what, guys?
Speaking of, hold on a second. I'm
gonna take Oh, wait.
I got a shirt. There you go. I should be wearing that.
Dude, and some of your ink is so interesting. Oh, is this a Samurai Jack?
Yeah, that's Samurai Jack.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I thought my whole arm is Samurai Jack.
That's sick, man. Between that and your love of Rick and Morty,
yeah, I love Rick and Morty.
You are immersed. No, I know you. You are brethren of the Rick and Morty. All right, let's get back to the matters at hand. Be serious here, as we go to this next photo.
Ooh, that's a classic.
Yeah,
that is me and Thad Frick going out. You're going out. That's me doing my jiu-jitsu. Look at that shirt. I crushed that night.
That was you did crush that
crushed.
Night.
Crushed.
All right.
I was a savage that night. I was not taking no for an answer.
Oh,
right?
Wow.
You know what they call the finishers, right? You know where that came from? That's right there.
Yep.
That's finishers.
I see it now. It took me a while, but now I fully see it.
Thaddeus Jones, shout out.
Boom. This one right here.
Oh, shit. That's back at the OG spot. I'm Baron Bowling Jarrell Garcia,
mm-hmm.
who's getting married. I'm going to be going to his wedding in San Francisco.
Awesome.
And then Zach's actually going to be the minister that marries him.
Oh, shit. That's a lot of responsibility for you guys.
Like, this is Zach's, third wedding.
Really?
That he's done. He's, people just ask him to marry him for some reason.
That's awesome.
People love Zach. I'm, at Bethlehem, I'm the dickhead that everyone, no one likes. And Zach's like, oh, we love Zach. He's so nice and hilarious.
Does that get old after a while?
No, I love it. I love being the...
Okay.
Because I just mold to what I need to be done, that needs to be done. But Jarrell's actually a brown belt out here on the West Coast now.
Mm.
And he's a savage. He's twistering people, stuff like that. And he was one of our first students. He came in I'm not going to come back. I can't be here for 3 more weeks, but I'm coming back. And we're like, yeah, whatever, dude. Stop wasting my time.
And then, boom,
he's one of our best buddies. You know what I mean?
That's awesome, man. Well, I love that you take on the Batman role,
I have to.
The gym. And look, before we go any further, Zach just wanted to let you know, boom.
Oh, fuck you, dude. How's that?
That's love.
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I love Zach.
Is there trouble in the podcast?
No. We love each other.
Are you guys... So, okay.
He talks shit. He did a podcast and he was talking shit on the podcast on
me. What up, biatch?
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, wow. You guys are talking to each other like
you're clueless,
apparently.
Is he talking Portuguese?
Apparently. No, he said biatch. And he just said ha-ha.
He hears. I'm talking shit.
My question to you is... In this oversaturated world of BJJ podcasts, why do you feel that you need to make one? Because most people who make BJJ and MMA podcasts, dead to me.
Yeah. Some people don't train. They talk about jiu-jitsu, they're making money off jiu-jitsu, they're not training.
That is true.
They don't train. You better be about this shit, because we're going to see you out here. And I better be about my shit, not saying that I'm better. I'm not better than anybody, so don't think I'm trying to say
fair,
that.
Every person who says that they're going to do a jiu-jitsu podcast, my first question is, do you train?
Yeah, you need to train.
Because they'll figure you out.
There's people that are trying to tell you stuff about making money in jiu-jitsu. Don't even train. What are you talking about? There's no money to be made for you. You know what I mean? This is you don't do stuff in jiu-jitsu to get paid. People will be I want to do this and that because it makes money. Dude, you have no idea. You're going to fail. You're going to fail. Mm-hmm. I've been doing this for free. Until next Sunday. Okay? This Sunday, Grace has made more money in jiu-jitsu than me. You know what I mean? I put everything I have into jiu-jitsu. It gives what you put in, but you ain't getting... There's no way you're making money in jiu-jitsu unless you're 1,000% about it. You know what I mean? You have to love this shit. And a lot of people do, but a lot of people also, they start shit with people, in between people. I've had people, bring me into beefs I'm not even involved with. It'll be a... this guy, he'll put up a match of me and some other dude. I didn't even say it. You didn't even talk to me about this. And now all of a sudden people on the internet are like, oh, I want to see who wins this fight. You didn't even talk to me about this. There's all kinds of stuff. But everyone I've met, I met Joey Fody from He's from Texas, the Jiu-Jitsu podcast. That guy's cool. Like, he's young. He's coming up. He's young garbage. In the game. Yeah. Is he garbage?
He's garbage as a human being.
What? I didn't know that.
Also as a broadcaster.
He was cool. We were at the Holland Invitational. He was all right. You know, I thought he was okay.
He's garbage. But here's the important thing is anybody with taste knows that.
Don't you guys talk... No, you guys talk shit to one another. That's why you're saying that.
I talk shit to everybody.
You talk shit to everybody.
Here's the reason why. First of all, don't come into my house and talk shit to me. Second of all, everybody wants to be the podcast. Like, you don't get into jiu-jitsu. Yeah. You don't get into jiu-jitsu. Like, I don't look at a competitor who goes, I want to be the best. And you're like, okay, cool. Don't be the best.
Right.
Like, all of us want our piece of the pie. And I think we all have our niches. I think we all serve certain kind of things that we do well. But, like, Joey comes over and, like, he's just like, he just starts being like, hey, my podcast is pretty good. And it's like, shut up, kid. Your podcast is garbage.
Oh, shit.
But here's the reason why I want to give him a lot of shit. So there's a moment where I think it was you and the Show the Art guys.
Yeah.
You all took a photo together. And he's like, hey, everybody, this is what it feels like when you're around good podcasts.
Yeah.
And I looked at that and I was just like, ha.
Yeah, you reposted that.
I reposted that.
You made a meme out of that.
I made a meme that said, oh,
jacked I am.
You're pretty jacked. But I said, look at you, Joey. You suddenly can talk shit now when you're around superior podcasts.
Yeah, like you got some muscle now.
Now you're talking shit.
I got the joke.
Yeah.
But Joey's the man, dude.
He's all right. Anyway. Well, you guys do have a nice, very laid-back approach. It's very chill-oriented. It sounds like you guys literally would hear that sort of stuff if you went to your gym. So there's always that great vibe that you guys present.
On the podcast? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, that's us. That's 100% us. We don't hold anything back on that podcast. We just wake up like we did today, and I just rip a cup of coffee, you know?
I mean, you are a soldier. You literally just woke up, and I was like, are you ready to do this? Or you're like, yeah, I just need coffee.
Coffee, and then we go. And, you know, we got so many stories. Like, dude, we got, like, we've been in martial arts so long. Like, between me and Zach, dude, Zach had his first pro MMA fight in 2001.
Mm.
So that he fought pro MMA and won like a title by knocking a dude out like a head kick in 2001. So we got stories for days, days. We used to like all kinds of stuff. So you know, and then building the school, we got stories for that, and you know, so there's a lot of interesting stuff to talk about, and we're doing like cool shit. Like we're coming out to EBI, we got Grayson EBI, so we kind of know a lot about what's going on. So we get to talk about current events and stuff and our take on it, because it's a new school approach as far as like how we train and how we, you know, our whole process of like how we do things sometimes, but it's like rooted in like old school shit, like respect and like a lot of that's missing. A lot of that's missing. Like the old school, like no one's getting taught I'm not saying no one, like a lot of people are not getting taught, like, because everyone's on the internet trying to get famous, you know what I mean? And, like, they're running their Instagrams a certain way, and they're running their Facebooks, and they're, you know, that's cool. Like, I've run my shit, too, but, like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Like, everyone's trying to just sell shit or whatever. I don't know.
Sure.
It's like, whatever. What you're, like, dude.
Here's the thing. A lot of people chase the actual intent of fame rather than the work of it.
And, like, I'm, like...
Like, there are a number of people who, I think you find them very quickly, and you can disseminate who's who very quickly, between, like, this person loves jiu-jitsu, they're all about it, they want this to be their life, and this person just kind of wants to be famous.
Yeah, because, no, it's like a tool to people use it kind of, like, to make money or something, right? Like, right away, like, you've been training for, like, a year and a half,
right?
You know what I mean? Like, what are you up to?
What are you,
and there's nothing wrong, maybe they got an idea that's going to make money or something, like, and they're smart business-wise. There's nothing wrong with that, but, like, I don't know.
Uh-oh. Look at this. We're getting some comments here. First of all, Nick Jordan said, are you guys high? Well.
How dare you, sir?
The second comment comes from...
This shit's bad for you.
Jarrell Garcia, who says...
Alcohol, guys. Drink alcohol.
My brother JM, the man.
Thank you, guys.
So, Jarrell, good to see you. Nico Radich says... I like this guy.
Nico.
Nico's fucking
powerful
beast.
Nico. Dude, he's 21. I found out he's that kid's 21.
I know, dude.
And I was pissed. Like, because, like, I'm 27, and I'm, like, the guys in the car, like, will pick guys up for seminars. I'll be like, how old are you? He'll be like, 32. I'm like, sweet. I still got time on this motherfucker, you know what I mean? Like, 21, and, like, I have a hard time tapping him, like, you know what I mean? And
yeah,
he tapped me. His leg locks are insane.
Really
sick
solid.
Darces. And, 21? Holy shit.
I know, dude. It's just, you know what it is? Fuck you, Nico. Anyway, Jarrell Garcia, Zach, and Jim are two of the hardest working guys in the game.
JM, dude. You're the person that makes my coffee in the morning. Like, when I go to Starbucks...
Actually, no, I read it wrong. That's me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, you're making fun of me.
Yeah, I'm making fun of you now.
Oh, I don't care.
I flipped the script.
You flipped nothing.
On your own shit.
On my own shit. Listen, kid. Every squirrel gets a nut every once in a day.
I was due.
So here's the thing, guys. We're now going to start talking a little bit about a couple things that have always been near and dear to my heart. Obviously, he's going to be competing over at EBI 11. You are involved in combat jiu-jitsu. So not just ordinary jiu-jitsu,
yeah,
but combat jiu-jitsu. You are one of the first people to be involved where slaps are allowed. My first question to you is, how many times have you guys played the Dave Chappelle bit with what did the five fingers say to the face?
I'm a big fan of the Chappelle Show.
Yes.
I'm so glad he's back. Yeah? Netflix just signed him for like $60 million.
They did. Three specials, I think, right?
That's sick. Yeah, I don't know. We love the Chappelle Show. That's every time like someone like I'll like be competing in like another tournament that's not Combat EBI, someone will be like, slap him! Like, you know what I mean? For the last like 6 months, you know what I mean? So, or like I'll get the, you know, when I told my students, I just put that actual meme like on the, we have like a group page that I keep in contact with all my students.
Yeah.
I'm like, guess what? This is Combat EBI. It's like Rick James.
Absolutely.
You know, that's cool though.
So when this did get brought up, you know, Eddie mentioned you as one of the first names. We had talked about this even the last time I saw you, that you were going to be doing this, and you were stoked. So now we're here.
Oh, I'm scared.
You're scared.
I'm so scared.
But why are you scared though?
Because I can get knocked out. I can get submitted. I can get embarrassed. I'm fucking scared. But yeah, I'm gonna be alright. I'm like legitimately scared. I'm not being funny. Like I'm legitimately shitting myself over this. But I'm gonna be okay. Like my style is like kind of. It's good for this, you know, we're going to just go out there and rep well and do my thing. And, you know, if I get to my spots and I'm patient, everything will be okay. I'm going to be fine.
What do you know about the other guys?
They're tough. I'm the only brown belt in the tournament and they're all jacked MMA dudes. I'm fucking scary, dude. Like, you know what I mean? Like, Eddie's like in class teaching. He's like, Jam's got to fight like three black belts. Beast. I'm like, what?
Oh, is that what? Is that your Eddie? Do you want me to? I can.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can.
That's Eddie a little bit.
Let me see. Hold on. Right here. I'll do my tuning fork real quick. Normally, if Eddie says the word beast, it's not just beast. It's that guy is a beast, man. He is so good.
Oh, no, he's not that. You put too much weed into it.
I put too much. Oh, so sorry. I put too much weed into it. Eddie Bravo.
He'll be like, he's so messed up. Yeah. I'm not.
The first person to ever say that. I want that to go down on tape.
No.
You're making him into East LA, Eddie.
Yeah, no, that was you. You did East
LA. No, you did East. It's like East. You didn't even know.
I thought you were trying to make it more sound East LA. Than
no, it's in the, like, it's like a gargle in the throat that you do multiple times.
But he's just in class saying, like, yeah, JM's got to fight these three guys, and they're all monstrous. I'm like, dude, come on, man. I'm scared.
So you're scared, but, like, you're not. Are you channeling that into excitement? Like, where is that for you right now?
I'm excited. I'm scared. It's a lot. It's a lot on my mind. Like, it's EBI. But if Grace can do it, I can do it. I'm not going to let her try to have one up on me. Like, you know, Grace, she's 14. She did it.
I mean,
so if Grace can do it, I can do it.
So talk to me about that, because where did you meet Grace? How did that happen? Because she is a phenomenon in jiu-jitsu, and rightly so. But, like, credit obviously goes to coaching as well.
Oh, no.
No?
No, she would have got good anyway. She would have got good. Anyone would have got her good. Anyone playing half a, you know, a little bit of attention, you know, show up once a week and teach her, they're fine.
But you're still the people in the gym,
weren't you? Yeah, no.
And I know that's
humbling. We worked hard with Grace back in the day, and Grace works, like, her ass off. And we have, like, a great support system. Like, we go, like, we got Eddie, and we have all the people that run 10th Planet Schools teaching, and we have, you know, we travel and train with so many cool people that also teach Grace. You know, she is unreal. But I met her, I've probably known her since she's been like six. And she's 14 now. So, and we've been together since, you know, and me, Zach, her, I've been together since Gangbusters, dude. Like, she got her black belt at like 6 years old in karate, which was like Kyokushin style. Like you could punch to the body, kick to the head, kick to the legs, kick to the body, knees, you know, takedowns. And then there was a grappling element to the test. You know, it's a 6 year old girl, but she doesn't, they were pissed giving her a black belt. Could you imagine giving a 6 year old girl a black belt? You'd be like, oh, they were like, I can't. But they're like, dude, she's good. And so they give her a, dude.
Thank you. Awesome. I also get my latte as well?
I might touch your wiener.
Cappuccino.
Soy latte, please. Thank you.
But yeah, Grace. What was I gonna say? Grace got her black belt, and then you know she had a decision to get her second degree black belt. She had to box to the head. She had to learn how to box to the head now, which sucks. Getting hit in your head sucks. So, you know, and at the same time, when that happened with her, I was getting into jiu-jitsu. So, like, I was working on my jiu-jitsu more and more because MMA wasn't working out. And I was like, you know, I want to learn how to, you know, I got held down in a fight. So, great. I just was like, hey, like, and Mary Jo was like, she didn't want Grace to quit. And Grace was getting bored because it's the same. Like, you get your black belt and it's just, like, time to retire.
Sure.
You know, I'm not learning anything new. You're eight. Like, she's like, yeah, I know all of it. Like, no. Like, so, like, me and her just start, like, first, like, I taught her mission control. Like, I taught her the omoplata. I taught her the crackhead, pump the elbows in the middle to the arm bar, crackhead control the arm bar. And I taught her meat hook triangle. And that's where it started, just those three rubber guard setups. And it just started clicking for her, too. I'm training with her 2-3 times a week. You know, for a while, she's beating good kids now. Like, she would lose, and then she's beating good kids. And then I opened my school, and she had a decision to make. Is she going to stay at the school she started with, or is she going to follow me? And for a while, she was kind of bouncing back and forth. And then her mom just like, dude, and we were just in someone else's gym. Mm-hmm. Like, no students. Me and Zach just getting ready, and she just made the jump and, like, came and trained with us after a while. And she has literally been with me since I've had no students. And she would come every day, 5 o'clock, and we would work together. And just lockdowns and rubber guard and understanding underhooks and overhooks and all the shit, spiderweb swim move, all the 10th Planet shit. And then she just added from, you know, all these different people, too. So she's got her 10th Planet games, like, her core, and then she's got, like, all this other shit.
Now she's just pulling stuff.
Yeah, and same thing with me and Zach, you know what I mean?
Sure. Let me ask this, though. Does she see the Matrix? Does she, like, there seems something very special about her.
Yeah, dude, she's not stupid. She knows how good she is. Mm. You know, she's 14. She strength trains. She like, legit lifts. Like, she does the workouts I do for EBI. Like, she's gangster. She doesn't do the exact same workouts. I lift more weights. Like, I'm heavier weights because I'm stronger.
For now. Give her time, individual. Man. Just letting her know.
Well, I'm letting her know that, you know, she really, if it really came down to it, I'll bust that ass.
Does,
you know,
she,
I mean?
First of all, no, let's really work on our phrasing here.
Opa, opa.
Does she buy into your nonsense? Does she enjoy, Grace, do you make her laugh?
Grace loves me, yeah.
Yeah, but do you make her laugh?
Yeah.
And people can like you, but me, you can make them
me
laugh.
And, yeah, yeah. Grace, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, she doesn't talk. And like, she don't talk to you. She don't like you. You know, she don't know who you are. You know what I mean? She's been with me for 7 years. You know what I mean? I can, we think very alike, like, and in martial arts sense. I'm not saying like in life sense, but like the way we do martial arts and our, you know, little things that, you know, you do, like, we're on the same page. Like, I don't have to talk to her because I know what she's thinking. Like, when she's competing, like, it's like a language. Like, I'll be like, I don't have to tell her what to do anymore. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, but she still looks to me for
guidance
stuff. And you know what I mean? Yeah. She'd be like,
you would do with anybody.
But I can do it in code. Like, I can be like, you know what's there. You know what's there. Mm. Go ahead. You know? And then she'll go. But, like, even in training and stuff, like, I'll say a joke or some shit. She'll laugh.
Does she have telepathy? Because I wonder these things.
No. Like, you spend 7 hours a day with somebody for 7 years, and I bet you start picking up what they think. What
I mean,
thinking.
Obviously, you can pick up nice cues and stuff.
I mean,
but
she's
she seems exceptional, and I think that watching her compete is truly there. And I love that she's used. I think she, of all the people, has really used EBI as the best showcase.
Dude, Grace is the shit. Great. It sucks that she can't be in EBI, but.
Saturdays. Over here, you guys can also find folks here. I believe we have Saturdays at 6 p.m. as well, depending on the weeks. But always check out the LA Jiu-Jitsu Club. You can find them on Instagram and on Facebook for more information, you guys. Casey Halstead just said, what up, guys? The incomparable.
What up, Casey?
Just a fucking gangster.
That guy.
He is that guy.
Powerful beard.
By the way, Casey, I want to let you know, I went to go do some secret shopping a couple weeks ago. Super Bowl weekend.
Super Bowl weekend.
Yeah. 10th Planet Costa Mesa, 10th Planet Orange. Orange looks like a spa. Like that thing looks like
brand new.
It looks immaculate. But everybody still there? Still pretty good. Eric, you don't get to say powerful Casey. Get out.
Powerful Casey.
Shut up. Darce Knight thinks he can just fucking walk in everywhere.
Diva!
All right. So tell me what you're excited about other than your matches at EBI 11. Who are you excited to see?
I'm excited to eat after EBI.
I'm excited that was to quite the question.
Have a beer.
Sure. Okay.
I'm excited to go home and see my girl. I'm excited to see my family, my dog. I'm excited to see my students. And maybe I win. Maybe I just don't want to look like an idiot. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Don't look like
you don't know what you're doing, and you'll be okay with whatever happens. Whatever happens. And then afterward, I want to see, dude, did you see Gordon Ryan's forearms on Instagram last night?
Yes.
What the fuck? That kid is a monster. Dude, he's got the muscle farm Johns like this.
Yeah.
The bottle shaker. Give me a bottle shaker. Do you guys have a shaker? You guys have a shaker right now? The muscle farm shaker is not as big as his forearm. His forearm, like right here,
mm-hmm.
right here, I've never seen anything like. Hold on, I'm gonna pull it up because these people need to see it.
That's fine. I'm sure we can.
They got a set because, dude, I was amazed. I was like, this kid.
No, he's.
I mean, he's been amazing.
I will say, okay, so look at his hood, right? So he had a hood on him.
Look at this forearm.
But let's talk about that. That hood makes him look like he's Grace Jones. Like, I'm all about every part of...
Dude.
It's impressive.
His forearms are insane. His abs. What? Jesus.
You guys getting enough of that? You like that?
I couldn't believe... We were talking about it last night, right, Drew? Yeah, dude. His forearms... Go on Instagram at Gordon Loves Jiu-Jitsu and look at that, dude. Unbelievable. Could you imagine doing jiu-jitsu with that body? Like, if you could just jump into... All right, this is a shaker, right?
Mm-hmm.
So look at... You can't even see my forearm.
Mm-hmm.
Like, look. Like, my forearm is skinnier than this shaker. His shit's, like, double that. But imagine, like, you got to play with that. Like, that was the... Like, it was like a Titanfall. Like, you could step into that body and just... That's what you did jiu-jitsu with.
Titanfall.
Same mental state.
Mm-hmm.
Same mind that you have. But you would just have this body to play. Like, that would be sick. Imagine how good you would be. Oh, my God.
So how did you transition to Gordon from that?
I don't know. What were we talking about?
Well, I was asking you what you were excited to see at EBI 11.
Oh, well, yeah. Gordon. I'm excited to see Gordon, like, kill somebody.
There we go.
That's sick. I'm excited to see Nathan Orchard and Boogie, my teammates. Those guys are fucking savages. Nathan is a beast. You see, won the EBI qualifier. You watch that?
No.
Four rear naked chokes. That's
huge. Impressive, man.
Four. Rear naked choke is not a heel hook.
It's not a heel hook.
You know what I mean? Like, you win four rear naked chokes, that's a big deal. It's not four heel hooks. I mean, same result, just there's a little different way of going about it. You know what I mean? It's dope. It's
still not a heel
strangling
hook.
Strangling everybody.
Let's do this, though, Jam. This is important to note. You mentioned this. You sold that great. But who wins?
Shit, I don't know. Dude, you know who else I'm excited to see? You know who I'm excited? That Lesbo Yanni kid. You know who that is?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. That kid's good.
Yeah?
What? He's so good. He's so good. Dude, he was a purple belt, like, mopping. You know who I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Dude, he's, like, six. He was 16, mopping, like, grown men. A lot of them. And he made them look stupid. Like, Gracie guy. Old school Gracie guy, like, sick jiu-jitsu.
Mm.
I'm a big fan of that kid's. And he's 18. This is his first one. And that's going to be sick. Wow. Wagner Roach is in it.
Yeah.
Right? Who else is in it? Give me some names.
Does Wagner know he's not doing combat jiu-jitsu, though?
I hope so.
Okay. That's my concern.
Stealing the show from me, Wagner. Please don't.
Andrew Ryan Murillo, in the background dying, said, "It's going to be sick. EVI combat jiu-jitsu." Except I didn't read it the way I read it in my brain, which is it sounded more like Mortal Kombat the way it was written. It's going to be sick.
Yeah, but dude, there's always some guy in like in EVI that's just not, maybe not the guy that wins, but some other dude that I'm still like, oh shit, that guy's dope.
We like to say, you know, the Dan or Death Squad obviously has been very dominant in it, but we like to say that there's always a showcase.
Well, last one we got one.
You did? Ted
Planet got one last
time. That's true. Gio had a fucking amazing performance on
those fakers at Ted Planet finally got one.
Well, that stuff doesn't work, though.
Yeah,
everybody knows that.
That shit don't work.
The important thing is, though, I feel like there's always a showcase role at every EBI I've seen. So, like you mentioned, it may not be the person who wins, per se.
Yeah.
But there's always somebody who stands out.
Right.
Even if they don't win. And I think their market value always rises because people are interested to see what happens here.
Yeah.
You expect the unexpected when you guys
watch
that.
People don't care, and I don't think there's people... Like, you want to win. Everyone wants to win.
Sure.
We can't all be, you know, Gary Tonin. That guy's a monster. Like, you know what I mean? What? Can't all be that guy. You know what I mean? But if you do cool shit, like if you throw cool stuff, like of course they're gonna have you back. Well, I want to see cool shit. Like, everyone wants to see you throw, and it's different because this, like, my style is different than this guy's style.
Sure.
Everyone's jiu-jitsu is different. So, dude, like guys like Daniel O'Brien, I love Daniel O'Brien. They're like, I'm huge fans of these guys.
Yeah.
And they inspire the shit out of me to get better because it's like, wow, there's so much game. Like, there's so much game. And there's so many different ways to just solve the same problem. It's sick.
Absolutely. All right, Eric. Ramey just said, what up, JM?
Powerful Eric Ramey. What up, dog?
So let me ask this. All right. You're already mentioning combat jiu-jitsu. It's happening. It's happening on March 5th.
Yes, sir.
6 p.m., Florentine Gardens in El Monte. Or Whittier, or one of the two. It's kind of all the same. You guys know where it is. I'm excited for it. I'm excited for you, sir.
Thank you.
I know that you've been excited about this for some time, and it's so great when you get to see your friends get the showcase and the vehicle to do what they do best.
I'm just happy to be there. to share the stage with these guys that are competing is truly an honor, and I'm excited to go down and do my thing for my team. I get to represent for my whole school, and it's amazing to be on that stage. So I'm just thankful to be here. I'm some kid from Bethlehem. I have no business. You know what I mean? Like, it's just, whew, right? We're going to do it.
You have reason.
Yeah,
you have business to be there.
I belong there, but, like, you know what I mean? I'm happy I'm here.
Well, that's good. We're happy you get to perform. Can we take care of any shout-outs before we get you on out of here in a second?
10th Planet, Bethlehem, Finishers Podcast. I was gonna shout out Show the Art, they can get one. Abe,
how did you guys come together?
Internet chat rooms. No.
That
was like a little thing. Like, we were thinking about a tournament, they were thinking about a tournament, and we just started scheming on some shit, and then next thing you know, it's tournament time.
I do like the both of you guys. I don't like
makes
the
sense.
Jiu-Jitsu podcast,
it makes
but
sense.
I like you guys.
Thank you.
As your own vehicles. And I
get it under Abe's skin a little bit. Abe's very Abe has like his little style to him, and I try to, if I can mess with him, he gets pissed off at me sometimes.
Does he? Why would he get pissed at you?
I curse when I shouldn't, or like I act like an idiot, you know. Some guys aren't like, you know what I mean? Like,
when are you supposed to curse though?
I don't know, all the time. You're supposed to behave.
I was like, listen.
Oh, shit. It's time to go train, dude.
Yeah, I know, dude. You need to get the fuck out of here.
Get out of here.
All right, guys.
Traffic.
Well, congratulations over our due to getting on the card.
Thank you for having me.
We're excited to see you guys. Keep it locked here at Verbal Tapcast. We are going to keep you guys updated. We have more interviews. Next week, we're going to be talking with somebody, an MMA fighter who has a fight coming up on March 18th. Good friend of ours named Thord Shanky. And obviously, for more shenanigans, Monday through Friday here at the LA Jiu-Jitsu Club, 7 a.m., come beat me up. Come beat up Eric Medina, Drew Murillo, Joey House, Octavio Villanueva.
That guy, Joey House.
If it's possible.
He smelled like shit, possible. Kind of, a little bit on his feet and on his butt crack.
Oh, wow. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's the good sign when the bad...
Thank you for the love, everybody.
...Portuguese accent comes through.
Boa, all right.
Oh, God, no. All right, guys. Have a good one.